Good evening. It's just hours before we have a verdict on the fiercely fought battle to White House, and it's turning out to be a nail-biting finish as opinion polls show both Obama and Romney in a neck-to-neck fight. But on We Mean Business today, amid all this excitement and anticipation, we look at just what the US elections mean from an India standpoint. Are we even on the radar as far as this election is concerned? And does it really matter to India who the next US president would be? Joining me to debate this and understand the complexities behind the Indo-US relationship and what the 2012 elections would mean in terms of steering it forward is Mr. Krishnakumar Natarajan, MD and CEO of Mindtree Consulting. He joins us from our Bangalore studio. Sunil Alag, Chairman, SKA Advisors, joins us from Delhi for an industry and economy perspective. And also joining us from the capital is Mr. Praveen Swamy, the resident editor at Hindu, for a foreign policy perspective. But before we start our debate, let's toss it over to NDTV's Namrata Brar in New York for a perspective on what these elections mean from an Indian standpoint. Namrata, does it really matter to India what the verdict is like?
In the near term, but on the longer term, you will see a different stance play out. Remember, historically, India tends to like Republicans more. At least they feel business is done easily. It tends to be a little more open, and they perceive Democrats to be more protectionist as far as the rest of the world goes. For Indian citizens, however, Democrats seem to be the favorite choice. So there is a difference amongst that as well, what the government likes versus what the Indian citizens like. In terms of translation into policy, two big issues for India. One would be outsourcing and second would be regulation. I don't think either will be affected from the candidates. There will be a concentration on US jobs, so you will see more local inward looking statements coming in, but there should not be a radical difference. So net, I think what happens to India is what happens to the rest of global markets. It will have to deal with that. Blue versus red, stars versus stripe, Obama versus Romney, both present an equally riveting case as far as India goes.
Okay, let's really start where Namrata left off. Mr. Krishnakumar, first, do you really believe from an India standpoint that there's not going to be any radical difference as far as an impact is concerned, whichever way the verdict goes?
See, if you look at the Indian IT industry, I think it's done well both under a Democratic president or a Republican president. I think the Indian IT industry is becoming very core to Fortune 500 enterprises, to the extent in the US, the Indian IT industry over the last several years has created close to about 238,000 jobs. It's not just the jobs, but professionals who pay fairly high taxes, and I believe that the Indian IT industry pays close to about 15.2 billion in taxes, which is growing at a compounded CAGR of about 15% over the last 5 years. So I think it's an industry which is impacting the local economy, creating local jobs, and clearly the industry has done well both under a Democratic as well as a Republican president. So I believe it is not going to have any impact on the Indian IT industry, irrespective of what the verdict is going to be.
Mr. Alag, what do you make of the fact that India has been so completely off the radar of both the presidents, be it in the campaign or during the debate? I mean, does that in some sense signal that, you know, India doesn't really stand anywhere as far as the US electoral process is concerned?
You know, it's very difficult for us to say who is good and who is bad for India. But if you look at the track record for the last decade or so, invariably we've always got more aid, we've got more business whenever there's been a Republican president, and we've got more talk and rhetoric whenever there's been a Democratic president, but with very little work or very little aid or very little industry coming in. Right from the time of John F. Kennedy, and if you take a look at all the Bill Clinton and even as well as Obama, there's a lot of drama about all the presidents that come from the Democratic range, but very little gets done. But somehow the Republicans, whom we don't really like and who are not very popular in India or the rest of the world, we've got the nuclear deal through, and we've get a number of things through. It's only when there's a Republican president, because I think the difference is that both of them talk the same language. Obama last time said he was going to cut down on outsourcing. They make these kind of noises, but it doesn't really happen. But the fact remains that business is pushed a lot harder under a Republican president than under a Democrat. So to that extent, I think the advantage would be with a Romney if we are to push things. But both of them are going to be for India, as the previous speaker said. But it's only a Republican president that has actually signed and got a lot of things done for India in the last decade. And that's just for record. It's because Obama lets it be. He lets industry move on its own. The Republican president tends to push industry into action, and the industrialists tend to thrive under a Republican president. That's my view, but I mean, who knows? I mean, as far as India is concerned, we've got enough to contend with as to who's going to be our next prime minister.
Mr. Praveen Swamy, I want to get your views really on who's relatively better between the Republicans and the Democrats. But before that, does it really worry you that India was mentioned a sum total of zero times in all of these presidential debates, when China, the Middle East, Israel, Pakistan, all of them got mentions of at least over 24 times?
I think it's a fantastic thing India wasn't mentioned at all. It means there are no significant areas of difference between India and the United States that impact on their domestic politics, and that's very good news. Having said that, I mean, I'm going to have to pick a bone with Mr. Alag's somewhat selective reading of Democratic-Republican benefits for India. George Bush's administration drove the US economy to the edge of bankruptcy, creating all kinds of problems. And there's a certain matter of a Republican administration which sent the US Navy into the Indian Ocean at the time of the Bangladesh War. So we've had problems with various regimes. But looking ahead, I mean, the big two challenges are simple. Mitt Romney would likely have meant a more aggressive United States policy on Iran and the Middle East, now, which is very bad news for India because it'll push oil prices up. We've already seen that happening with very, very limited US intervention in the region, and greater US intervention, particularly to do with Iran, would have terrible consequences for our economy, would undermine the very foundations of our economic growth. And that's been a big problem here. The second interesting thing is going to be what the United States does on Pakistan, which will obviously impact on regional security and very directly on India. In a year and a half from now, US troops will be out of Afghanistan. There are two potential ways this could go. The US could disengage from the region and leave Pakistan to its devices, or it could come down very much harder on Pakistan. Neither candidate has really laid out a blueprint from what they intended to do, but we'll need to watch this very, very carefully.
All right, Mr. Swamy, in fact, I want to get more of your views on foreign policy. But before that, Mr. Alag, you know, you did allude to the fact that Republicans are generally seen as being better for business. But this time around, both sides, given the problems that the U.S. is facing.
You know, I think the rhetoric is more inward looking from the Democrats than it is from the Republicans. And I agree with the previous speaker that, look, politically, what the problems that he's talking about in the United States affects the world. It's not just India. So now, is Obama better for the world or is Romney better for the world, becomes another debate. I think what we are talking about, some things which are beyond the world implications and what are specific to India. And I think from the Indian point of view, at this point of time, whether it's the Indo-Pak relations or whatever, it's reached a stage where neither the Democrat or the Republicans can back out of what they are doing in Pakistan and the support that they need India. I think they've reached a stage where he was right in saying in the Bangladesh War, the Republicans were not really for us because Nixon had a problem with Indira Gandhi. But that was more personal. I always find that all the right things are said by the Democrats. All the popular presidents are from the Democrats. The unpopular ones and the wrong things are always said by the Republicans. But when you sit down and see that whenever there has been a Republican president, has there been more actual stuff done for India? It's always been under a Republican president, and I'm willing to stand by that statement.
Okay, Praveen Swamy seems to be disagreeing there with you, but Mr. Krishnakumar, would you, as an IT industry doyen, really be happier with a Republican candidate at the helm, given the sort of protectionist backlash that we've seen from the Obama administration?
No, like I mentioned earlier, I think the Indian IT industry has done well both under Democratic president or a Republican president. And if you watch the last few elections, there's always been a rhetoric on outsourcing just prior to the presidential elections, because it's only natural that you talk what you want the voters you to be talking. But clearly this in no way is going to impact, because once the elections are done, I think technology is becoming such a core element of Fortune 500 global enterprises that the need to work on a collaborative model with the Indian IT industry is being felt. What I think has not happened in the last few years is because of the way both the Senate and the House of Representatives have been positioned. I think very little constructive progress has been made on solving some of these issues. So from an Indian IT industry point of view, if the objectives which both the presidents, either one of them, would drive, which is to fix the local economy, to create jobs, which will make America far more robust in terms of outlook. And that's great for the Indian IT industry, because that's our largest market. So I won't see that either one of them are going to be a beneficial factor for the Indian IT industry. We will do well under either one of them.
So, but you've definitely had a much better innings during the Republicans. I mean, if you just look at how life has changed for IT companies in the Obama regime per se, we've had H-1B visas come down, for instance, from an all-time high of 1.95 lakhs all the way down to 65,000.
That's right. I think any comprehensive immigration change would certainly help us be far more proactive in how we grow the business. But essentially, if you look at the Indian IT industry, has moved away from a labor cost arbitrage model to really ensure that you are involved in the core business of large enterprises, which really means you need to be local to the customer, which is one reason why I talked about the number of jobs which the Indian IT industry has created, 238,000. Also, if you have seen in terms of recent directions which most IT companies have taken, is to really be close to the customer, because you're doing something which is extremely critical for the customer, so you need to be local and closer. So I think by and large the visa regime is not in any way constraining the growth of the Indian IT industry. And I think like any other administration, when they do not have clarity in terms of how that comprehensive immigration is going to look at, there would be some short-term fixes which may not be the right ones.
All right. Before, in fact, I come to Mr. Praveen Swamy for a more foreign policy sort of perspective. Mr. Alag, from a business standpoint, we've had Obama coming into India, signing that $10 billion deal. We've had Bernanke being the first Federal Reserve chief, in fact, coming and visiting the country. Timothy Geithner and Hillary Clinton have both come pretty often. Is this enough, do you think? Has India really sort of exploited the full potential of its relationship under the Obama administration? And if not, how can the Romney administration be any different or better?
You know, the only thing under the Obama regime, as I said right from the beginning, both I think all of us are agreeing that there's not much of a difference between the two for India, except that whenever there is a deal and a direction given by the President of the United States of America, entire industry in America moves with speed. They tend to facilitate speed. They tend to facilitate the growth of business in America. They facilitate investments outside America. They really move it. In Obama's case, he says the same things as Romney, and then he sits back and gets involved in international foreign policy, and he leaves the industry alone to see, okay, how do you want to do it? So I think the only difference, and I keep emphasizing, the only difference is that under Romney or under a Republican president, from the point of view of business and business alone, India has always benefited much more than a Democratic president, because they tend to push things. The president seems to ask more questions from business, tends to ask them, what are they doing? Why are they not generating employment? Why are they not earning money than Obama's than a Democratic administration? Because they seem to have a more socialistic leaning, and the other one has a more capitalistic leaning. Of course, they're both democracies. But all over and every year, now I understand that you know, that today we've reached a political situation where India cannot be ignored. 10 years ago, a Republican or a Democrat president could ignore India at the expense of Pakistan and say Pakistan is our ally. I think that's been understood by both presidents. So I don't see any change in that area. So I'll remain the same, whether it's Obama or Romney, but I still come back that somehow the Republican president is very business oriented. They tend to come from a business background. All of them, whether I'm not saying who's good or bad, whether it's a Bush, whether it's a Romney, they all come from a business background.
But and given how preoccupied he's going to be,
scholars, you know, great visionaries and everything else.
Sir, but given how preoccupied he's going to be really with the domestic issues, do you really see
emphasis that a president lays?
So my question is, given how preoccupied he's going to be with the domestic issues, do you really see a scope in a lot of these pending issues, these niggling issues being sorted? The Indo-US nuclear deal, for instance, I mean, that's stuck in balance. How do you really see Romney changing that, if at all?
No, because, you know, like, okay, let's take the nuclear deal, which Manmohan Singh, our prime minister, fought, got through the parliament. What deals have been signed between America? Obama came and he said all our guys are coming to set up plants and help you with the power project. Has a single deal been signed? All I'm saying is, if it had been a Republican president, by now we'd have a lot of deals. India would have got more employment, people would have got power, which would have become cheaper. I'm still sticking with what I'm saying, and you watch, in case Romney wins, you watch suddenly in the next 12 to 24 months how much of investment flows in from America, unless of course we, for political reasons, stop foreign direct investment, because you've got another political animal which is going on in parliament today, which is not realizing how important this is.
All right, clearly Mr. Alag has strong views as to how really Romney could change the economic landscape of the relationship. But Mr. Praveen Swamy, from a foreign policy standpoint, how really could Romney be different from Obama? And in that context, how really would life change for India?
Mr. Romney certainly adopted a more aggressive posture, threatened to adopt a more aggressive posture on the Middle East. He's been using language which is considerably more harsh on Iran than Barack Obama has. He's been critical of Obama for going slow on adopting a more aggressive set of measures to contain Iran's nuclear program. And for us, this is a vital concern. It's not foreign policy versus the economy. What the United States does in the Middle East has direct consequences for us. Protracted conflict in the Middle East will mean high oil prices, which are at a historic high and will undermine our economy substantially. Any sort of, you know, destabilization of the regional order will mean all sorts of political forces inimical to India will emerge. Groups like Al-Qaeda and so on are already flourishing in Syria. And number three, this will have consequences for the massive Indian diaspora today making a living in the Middle East, whose remittances are absolutely vital for this country. We still haven't recovered from the income Indians were making in Libya, for example, still has not been recovered. So we can only hope that we have a government in Washington that is sensitive to our concerns. And that does not behave like a bull in the China shop, which it's done for many, many years now.
Actually, what you're saying is that if Iran is really going to dominate foreign policy at White House, how is India going to strike that delicate balance? Because we haven't yielded to pressure on Iran. We've got concessions as far as the oil issue is concerned. You know, if Romney does come in, it's going to be a delicate balance that the Indian government will have to strike as far as Iran is concerned.
It's going to be a delicate balance whether Obama comes or Romney, because the screws are going to be turned on us. We've already had to scale back our imports from Iran. But that's the smaller part of the jigsaw puzzle. We can scale back imports from part A of the world and compensate them by growing our imports from Saudi Arabia. Other countries like Korea and Japan are also struggling with these questions. But the big picture is that for the last decade or so, oil prices have been successively inching up towards historic highs. The great development of our East Asian neighbors took place at a time of low oil prices. That's true as well of the United States and of post-war Europe. At the precise time when we're taking off, the fuel of an economy is becoming more expensive than ever before. This is something that's going to hurt China, of course, but it's also something that's going to hurt us. and our foreign policy has to be focused on doing something about this. Compared with the potential consequences of these big foreign questions, issues like outsourcing are small change, and they aren't talked about enough in this country, but these are huge geostrategic issues of great import. The second question is Pakistan. If we have a United States that fails in coming years to tackle the Pakistan problem because it becomes inward looking and navel gazing, 5 years, 10 years from now, we could be confronted with a Pakistan that has collapsed in on itself. And anyone who thinks India can is just talking complete nonsense. Our energy security, our major industrial states, our major agricultural states are all perched on the edge of Pakistan. And what the US does there is going to be a vital consequence for us.
Right. Very quickly.
With Barack Obama, we've seen some signs of sense. What Mr. Romney may or may not do, we don't know. But we're certainly going to have to get our act together and lean on Washington very hard to make sure our voice is heard over the next 4 years.
Mr. Alag, very quickly, another important issue that's really pending is India's permanent membership on the United Nations Security Council. You know, what really happens if Romney comes in? Do you think he's going to push harder?
You see, look, I mean, whatever you think, Obama has always been a president, at least for the first term, and I think nothing is going to change dramatically for the second term, where he doesn't have the majority in either the Senate or in the House. So he has to rely on the Republicans to get anything through. Whereas if Romney comes in, he doesn't have to depend on anything. He just, whatever he decides, he's going to move it. So whether it's at a political level with Pakistan, whether it is at a business level with India, today as things stand in America, Romney has a better chance of pushing things through the US Senate and the House than Obama has. And Obama, personally, I prefer. He's the more popular guy. Romney, I don't prefer. But they're like food for India, you know. Anything that's popular and tasty is never good for your health. And the guy who's unpopular is generally good for your health. So from the health point of view, I still think from India's economy point of view, Romney is better because he has control in the House. He has control in the Senate. If we convince him about our cause, we move much faster and quicker.
Just one quick question to Mr. Krishnakumar. You know, the diaspora angle. We have 6 Americans this time running for the House of Representatives. Polls suggest that 3 have bright chances of winning. How is that really going to change the dynamic of the Indo-US relationship?
No, I think it's very, very positive. Take a state like Louisiana or any other place where people with Indian origin have really created a mark for themselves. I think the Indian diaspora getting into mainline politics would of course sort of ensure that some of the logical views which we have, like either Praveen or what Sunil said, is being heard far more and it's being acted upon.
Last word, Mr. Praveen Swamy, before we actually wrap up the show. You know, on Friday, we also have the Chinese transition happening. Romney, I beg your pardon, has been a rather vocal critic, calling China a currency manipulator. You know, how is that dynamic really going to work, if at all the Republicans have voted in? How is the sort of dynamic between India, China and the United States going to work?
I think it should worry India quite deeply if the China-US relationship starts deteriorating. It could do so for a number of reasons: rising nationalism in China, a more aggressive set of concerns about trade in the US. I'm not sure this is widely appreciated in corporate India, but the 5 or 10 good years we've had until now have happened in a very sort of warm, gentle international environment. We're coming up to a world now which is changing very rapidly, that is more unstable than at any point in the past. And it's going to take a lot of Indian foreign policy effort, a lot of Indian corporate effort to get our concerns heard. We're heading into a period of great instability, and the ability of Washington to manage that change should worry us. Certainly nothing that's happened in the last several years gives great cause for confidence.
Right. You like Obama, but you think Romney is better for India. Very quickly, who would you vote for?
Well, from the Indian point of view, I'd vote for Romney. From my personal point of view, I'd vote for Obama. But we have to wait and see what America thinks. It's a neck-to-neck finish. And look, from all points of view, if the Chinese people don't manipulate their currency, it actually helps India because their products are artificially right. kept at low prices. So from all points of view, Romney will be better for India. But personally, I'd vote for Obama.
Mr. Krishnakumar, very quickly.
From the Indian IT industry point of view, none. But personally, probably Barack Obama.
Well, this house is not as divided then as the electorate, but it's going to be an exciting few hours as we await the final results. What would be really interesting to see though is how the next president, whether Romney or Obama, we still don't know, approaches India at a time when economically perhaps we've dwarfed a little, but strategically and geopolitically we've probably assumed more importance than ever for the US. A big thank you to all our guests and thanks for watching.